point, I'm going to stop talking personally and let the puppets do the talking. What I do want to mention to you is that to perform a character like this, it's a standard hand rod character. I need not only my right hand to perform the mouth up here in the head, but I also need my left hand to control both arms, very much like eating with chopsticks. But it becomes very difficult as a solo puppeteer to do any kind of comedy bit where you need two characters talking with each other, because you would need four hands, or you would need to learn how to clone yourself. Fortunately for all of you today, I've learned how to do that, thanks to a little invention I have called the PRSVP, otherwise known as the pre-recorded self-contained virtual puppet. And if you could just bear with me for a second. I'll switch gears here. Gotta love technology.
Presumptuous? I don't even have a TV show yet.
I know it seems a little strange, especially since most networks
which is
where we go. Very good. And music.
What the heck is this? Hermit! Hermit! Just stop right there! What are you doing?
This happens to be a very classic theme song, Scrap.
But you're in black and white.
Oh, come on, no. Just because I'm not in color does not diminish
the
whole
song, of Frog.
Today's show couch, here I come.
Ah!
So, that is puppetry. I want to really get into talking and answering questions and everything, but the one part that I still want to show you guys is how puppetry can come full circle. At the animation studio that I've been working at, there's also storyboard classes that students can take. And I'd worked on this completely separate from the puppet stuff, although Scrap makes an appearance in some of the storyboards. And when I go to the conference in June, they suggest that puppeteers take a script with them that they could develop. What you're going to see now are some illustrations that I've drawn, and you see that it could be a storybook, it could be animation, it could be puppetry, and you see how all of this is really intertwined and how ultimately puppetry is this all-inclusive art form. So let me just call that presentation back up. So, we start off with Scrap, much younger than what you just saw now, more in the four or 5 year old range. And the story opens up with Scrap and his dad, and it's late at night. They're talking about the stars and outer space and all the stories associated with constellations and the beauty of the universe. And they do this every night, Scrap and his dad, and it's his favorite thing about spending time with his father. And Scrap looks out every night and just sees the beauty of it all. Like most of us, Scrap's father eventually passes away, but for him it was much too early, before Scrap ever had a chance to fall in love or raise a family. And as day turns into night and night turns into day and time starts to pass on, Scrap becomes a teenager in the eyes of the story. And every day, Scrap walks down from his home in an observatory down to this very provincial town to try to show these townspeople just how awesome the universe could be. And every day, he gets this really blank slate of a reaction from people. And every day, he tries to show them something more and more interesting to try to convince them how great it is. But all he ever gets is people scratching their heads. So every night, he goes back home to his room in this observatory and looks out at the night sky to see a star vanish from the sky. He sees a star extinguish every night. Now, this all changes one day as he's walking into town in the morning and notices for the first time a monster just like him. And he's so caught by her beauty that he actually drops all the stuff out of his bag as his telescope rolls down the hill. And she picks it up for him and tries to help him out. When he sees that it's someone just like him, he invites her for the first time to his observatory to look at the night sky because she actually has some interest in what he has to say. And as they talk about the stars, just like he used to with his dad, for the first time since his father passed away, a star is relit in the sky. This process repeats for a while, and as they start to talk more and more and spend more time with each other, the conversation shifts from just talking about the universe to talking about friendship and life and what it means to be a part of the world. And the more and more they do this, the more and more stars are lit back up in the sky. And finally, one night, they decide to look out at this broad new canvas that they realize that they had some part in creating, and they realize not only what great friends they were, but how this friendship has turned into love. And upon this realization, the last bit of paint is added to this canvas, and that's the moon, which, as days turn to night again, they're able to share with a brand new family.